This is the best mechanism I've seen anywhere yet. I think that Measures for Justice is the answer.
Measures for Justice is a system of performance measurement for local criminal justice. We measure county level criminal justice because that's where the most important criminal justice decisions are made.
When we looked at the Measures for Justice data portal, we saw that Philadelphia had a higher rate of violations for pretrial release. The data allowed us to understand that we had to decrease the rate of violations. When we put our social services staff to that front-end analysis, 90.3% of those who received that social service intervention plan actually did well. They made it to court in the first appearance, and they stayed arrest-free during that pretrial status.
In my county, we have a county commission form of government. They allocate my budget every year. The more data I can give them, the better decisions they can make for our office. When I first took a look at the data from Measures for Justice, there were four of them that stood out to me. Time to disposition of felonies and misdemeanors, number of dismissals, and number of felonies that are pled down to misdemeanors. Historically, we've had difficulty getting staffing level increases. This year, I was asking for four. During our most recent budgeting cycle, the data from Measures for Justice was a significant component in my arsenal. I strategized the budget presentation around the measures that we were able to show our county commission. Here's how we stack up. We'd like to try to do better, but we definitely don't want to fall back. We got our full request met, which is the first time that's happened since I've been county attorney in 2007.
One of the measures that stuck out to me was our indigent jail population in Winnebago County. When we looked at the measure and looked at our jail population, what we found was that about half of the people who were sitting on cash bonds of $500 or less. Based on that metric through Measures for Justice, we set up a study to track what was happening. One of the big issues was holidays and weekends. There was nobody processing the cases. What we found is that 78% of them are being given a signature bond, but they're sitting on average 2 days in jail until they see a judge. In our county alone, the fiscal impact works out to be about $45,000 per year. So I waived the appearance for the district attorney's office for all of those matters, so that when the judge is called in to do those probable cause determinations, they could also release people.
Particularly for policymakers and practitioners, Measures for Justice really provides them with the data that they can use to make informed policy decisions.
This is going to be one of the most useful tools in the history of the criminal justice system in the United States of America.